Hello, good morning students. First of all, I welcome all the students in this online class. Today my topic is phrases and clauses. Before I tell you the definition of phrases and clauses, I would rather show you what is a sentence and what it is comprised of. Comprised means किसी चीज से मिलकर बना हुआ. Now we know the definition of a sentence. Sentence. The sentence is a group of words that contains a subject and a verb and makes complete sense by itself without depending on any other word or group of words to do so. For example, he came here in the morning. It has a subject and the subject is he, and also has a verb and verb is came and makes complete sense by itself. Now students, I hope you have some understanding about a sentence. Phrases and clauses. Now we will know about phrases and clauses purpose. Phrases and clauses are the building blocks of sentence. They need to be put together correctly to create strong, complete sentence. Now students, we will learn the definition of phrase. A phrase is a group of words that does not contain a subject and a verb and does not make complete sense. Means phrase doesn't have a subject and doesn't have verb and doesn't make complete sense. For example, at the village in the evening, an affectionate father. Now we will see the definition of clauses. A clause is a group of words that contains a subject and a verb and is a part of a sentence. As we learned that phrase has a phrase doesn't have subject or doesn't have a verb, but the clause have a clause have a subject and verb and it is a part of a sentence. For example, because he was late, here he is subject and was is verb. If he writes at all, here he is subject and writes is verb. As he walked along the road, here he is a subject and walked is a verb. Phrases and clauses can form parts of a sentence. Look at the following sentences. He missed the train yesterday because he was late. The first part of the sentence, he missed the train yesterday, has a subject and the subject is he, and a verb also, and the verb is missed and makes complete sense. It is called the main clause of a sentence. It has also another clause, because he was late. As we learned that clause has a subject and also has a verb and it is a part of a sentence. Which does not make complete sense on its own. It has a subject and verb, but it doesn't have complete sense on its own. This clause is dependent on the first part of the sentence to complete its meaning, so it is called the subordinate clause. Hope students, you all have understood about phrases and clauses. Now we will see the exercise from our book, The Grammar Tree. Exercise A. Read the following and decide whether they are phrases, clauses or sentences. Write P, C or S against each phrase, clause or sentence. First, the beautiful dance. It doesn't have subject and a verb, so it is phrase. Second, I forgot all about it. It has a subject and verb, so and it also has complete sense by itself, so it is sentence. Third, don't waste time over silly matters. This sentence is also has complete sense by itself, so it is also a sentence. While she was cleaning the dressing table, it has a subject and verb, but it doesn't have complete sense, so it is clause. Have you ever seen a rhino? It is an interrogative sentence, so it is a sentence. A new day. It is a phrase because it doesn't have a subject and a verb. In spite of their loyalty. It doesn't have a subject and a verb, so it is also a phrase. What a pleasant surprise it was. It's an exclamatory sentence, so it is a sentence. As he walked along the road, it also has a subject and verb, so it is but it doesn't have complete sense by itself, so it is a clause. Although they pretended not to hear the loud protest, so it also has a subject and verb, but it doesn't have complete sense, so it is also a clause. Some more sheets of paper. It doesn't have a subject and a verb, so it is a phrase. If he writes at all, it has a subject and verb, but it doesn't have complete sense, so it is a clause. Hope you all have understand about the phrases, clauses and a sentence. Students, please do practice by yourself at your home. Thank you so much.